Hey, and welcome to this short video tutorial. I'm going to show you how to rename large amounts of files with a few clicks. For this workflow, you need the free software Renamer. It's available at den4b.com. The link will be in the description. Open the software. And click on Add Files or Add Folders. I'm going to choose these Windows sample pictures to rename. Let's start with a simple example. I want to insert the word pig in front of every file name. I click on Add. I'm on Insert. I'm going to add a space at the end to make it more readable. I choose Prefix and click Add Rule. The lower half of the program window shows a preview of the new file names before the changes are actually applied. Now click Rename, and you can see the files have changed in Windows Explorer. You can also delete a certain part of the file name. Let's remove the word pick again. I select Delete and choose the range of characters I want to remove, from position 1 to position 4. As you can see, the word pig has been removed in the preview. I could also remove the characters up to a certain character or a word by using the delimiter field. Remove is similar, but removes only the characters I type in. Replace should be self-explanatory. I want to show you some more advanced renaming functions. You could, for example, change the casing of the names. Or you could serialize them, which adds numbers to the file name. You can also insert meta tags, like file size or an MP3 title. Or a size of an image. If you want to add the current date, you can choose Date Now. You can choose how this date is formatted in the settings. You can customize the columns by right-clicking the column headers. This way you can choose what to sort your files by. You can also drag them to sort. The sorting is useful if you want to give them serial numbers. There are many more advanced rules for renaming files, like transliteration, which transforms words from one alphabet to the other, like the German umlauts to AE, OE, and UE, or you could add random characters into your file names. Just play around with these rules and combine them together to reach the result you want.